You've heard it before. I will repeat it today, but faith is the currency of heaven. Faith is very important to God, and thus it is important in the life of the believer. Hebrews 11:1, in that great faith chapter, describes faith as the substance, the stuff of things hoped for, and the evidence or the proof of things not seen. Faith is so important to God that in his sovereignty, he has decided that no man could please him without faith. Any Bible readers in the house? As a matter of fact, Paul in his epistle to the church at Ephesus says that it is by grace through faith. And that not of ourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. To put that in its simplest form, faith is believing God, taking God at his word. I'm in here by myself today. No matter how dismal the situation may look, no matter how impossible the obstacles in your life may be, that I believe God that if he said it, he shall surely bring it to pass.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Our ancestors who have been in and delivered from the oppressive and abusive hands of the slave masters look back over their lives and declare in song that we have come this far by faith. Leaning on the Lord.
Yeah.
It said, I was trusting in his holy word and it never failed me.
Yeah.
And say, right now, I believe that is a good place for us to stop and praise God because life is not always going to be a bed of roses. Somebody ought to be able to admit that there were some days in our lives when we didn't know just how we were going to make it out. All of our friends were nowhere to be found. Mama and Daddy could not help us. And the doctors said that they have done all that they could do. Everybody told me just to give up and just to throw in the towel, but I was crazy enough to believe God. And God took what little faith I had and came to my rescue. Old folks used to say that God is a God who specializes in things that seem impossible. And that he can do what no other power but Holy Ghost power can do. And so in essence, God is looking down upon us and he said, I've got the power, but do you have the faith? I really wish I could stay right there, but I got to get back into our text because in our text, we see James, the half-brother of Jesus, and he is directing our attention again to the subject of faith. And this arrested my attention because James, in the second chapter of his epistle, makes a startling declaration. This declaration that he has made has baffled the mind of many of biblical scholars. Because James declares that that faith without works is dead. That there is much debate in the religious world about faith and works. Really, it's probably one of the most controversial passages in the Bible. I know we read it and we skip right over it. But this debate between faith and works is age old. I would not have us to be ignorant. And I would tell you that there are two schools of thought concerning this passage of scripture. One is an overemphasis on faith.
Preach it.
While forgetting altogether works. And the other school of thought is an overemphasis on works. While forgetting all about faith. And I believe that the problem arises when people fail to make the distinction between the requirement of salvation and the result of salvation. I hope you hear me. And so when Paul says that salvation is by faith and not of works, and James turns around and says that faith without works is dead, they are not contradicting one another. They are complementing one another.
Preacher.
That they're not standing toe-to-toe in opposition to one another. That they're really standing back-to-back as two sides of one coin. The Bible over and over plainly teaches us that salvation is by faith alone in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. But the Bible also teaches that true faith will always result in good works. You might not like that, I'm going to preach it anyhow. Don't misunderstand me. James is not saying that works is a condition of salvation. But what James is saying is that works are the natural result, or the fruit, if you will, of a believer walking by faith. Say, man, I think that's important for us to understand. Because Jesus said, I am the vine. And you are the branches. He said, if you abide in me and I abide in you, the same shall bear much fruit.
My God.
Seasoned saints used to put it this way. If you got good religion, you ought to show some time. Because faith that is not evidenced by works is a fruitless and a dead faith.
Preach.
I know I see y'all don't like me, but I want to just give three truths out of this text, and I'll get out of your way. First thing I see in the text is that a faith without fruit is a false faith. Look at verse 14. What doth it profit, my brother, though a man say he have faith and have not works, can faith save him? James here defines the principle. He's not speaking of one who actually has faith, but he's talking about somebody who claims to have faith. His emphasis is on one who has a false claim rather than a real faith. He is contrasting what a person claims to have and what he really has. Don't you know that we are not Christians just because we say we are? You say that you are saved doesn't make you saved. Somebody put it like this, everybody talking about heaven. Ain't going there.
Help us today.
Live in a world where there are a whole lot of people making a lot of claims, but not many folks have conviction. Let the world tell it today. 85 to 90% of all of America is a Christian. 16. He says, if a brother or sister be naked and destitute of daily food, and one of you say unto them, depart in peace, be ye warm and filled, notwithstanding ye give them not those things which are needful for the body. What does it profit? He says, in a sense, if you got it by you to do, and you're saying that you are a man, a woman, a child of God, and you can just walk by folks who are in need, that talk is just cheap.
Praise.
I've shared this illustration with us before, but I'll share it one more time. I told you about a man who was walking in the woods, and for whatever reason, he fell into a deep hole, so deep he could not get out on his own. He's screaming, help, help, I'm in a hole. Somebody help me. Somebody save me. There was a prayer warrior just at that time walking through the woods, and he heard the cries of this man who was falling into this hole. Prayer warrior looks over into the hole and he sees the man. He says, help! Help me out of this hole. And the prayer warrior looks down and says, I can't help you out of the hole. It's too deep. I'm going to fall in there with you, but I'm a prayer warrior.
And
here's what I can do for you. I can pray for you.
My God.
Prayer warrior begins to pray, and my God, he shook heaven with the prayer, but after he said in Jesus' name, amen, he gets up and goes on his merry way. Leaving the man stuck in his situation. So the man says, well, I got a mighty prayer, but I'm still stuck in the hole. Help! Help! Somebody save me!
Yes, sir.
I'm stuck in the hole. And just then a choir member was walking by, heard the cries of the man stuck in the hole. Looked down into the hole. Sir, what am I doing for you? I see you're stuck in the hole. I'm stuck in the hole. I can't get out. Well, I can't get in there with you. I won't be able to get out, but I'm a choir member. And what I can do for you is I can sing you a beautiful song. And the choir member began to sing like angels in heaven. And after he got done singing, got up and went on his merry way. That man said, that song was powerful. Really touched my heart. But I'm still in the hole. Man, after thinking about it, he said, man, I got a powerful prayer and a beautiful song, but I'm still stuck in the hole. Help, help, somebody. Save me. I'm stuck in the hole and I cannot get out. Just then a preacher was walking by and he heard the cries of the man. He looked into the hole. Saw the man stuck there. Can you help me, sir? No, I can't help you. The hole is too deep. If I get in there, I'll get stuck with you. But I am a preacher, and I can give you a word from God. That preacher whipped out his Bible and began to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. The man got the shout in the hole. After he finished, he got up and went on his merry way. Leaving the man
in the hole.
The man said, I got a powerful prayer. I got a beautiful song. And all that I get a word from the Lord. But I'm still stuck in the hole. Help, help, somebody. Save me. I'm stuck in this hole. And there's nobody. Walking in the woods about that time. Here's the cry of the man, and he goes to see about it, and he says, sir, what seems to be the problem? I fell in the hole, and I can't get out. Without question, that nobody of a man jumps into the hole with the guy. The man in the hole said, you fool! Now we both stuck in the hole. He said, be quiet, man. I've been in this hole before. I know the way out. It's almost like when you go out to eat at the restaurant.
Yeah, yeah.
And you know how we do sometimes when it's time to pay and you with a group, it's time to go to the restroom. And you go to the restroom. And when you come out, the bill is paid. And the guy, whoever paid it, says, I already paid it, man. You good.
Yeah.
And if you come out and you say, what? Prove it. And he pulls out a receipt.
Yeah.
That's the proof.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus paid it all on Calvary.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna go around the circle. 19.
Yeah.
James says, thou believest that there is the one God. Thou as well.
Uh-huh.
But the devil also believed.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah.
And trembled.
Yeah.
Listen, you can be hermeneutically accurate and homiletically sound and still have dead faith.
All right. My God.
Fruitless and futile faith. We walk around with our chest puffed out.
Yeah, yeah.
Our nose is all stuck up. Because we believe that Jesus is the only way.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah. James said, that's good, but that alone is really a demonic thing.
Yeah.
Because the demons believe that they're one God.
Yeah.
The demons got more good theology than you do. That faith without works And the man whose faith is fatal is the man that says that he has faith, that says that he is saved, but thinks that he can live however he wants. And Jesus says, that man is a fool. Those who have a faith, a fruitless faith that is fatal, those are the kind of folks that have a lot to say.
Yeah.
Always talking, but they ain't got anything to show. Got a whole lot of talking, but no walk.
Yeah.
Got a whole lot of believing, but no behavior. We read the scriptures, but we don't obey the scriptures.
Yeah.
And Jesus says it's very interesting. He said, whoever not just believes he's saying the mind, hears he's saying the mind and does it or puts it into practice.
Yeah.
He is like a wise man who built his house upon a rock.
Yeah.
And the Bible says that the rain descended and the flood rose up and then the winds blew all around the house.
Yeah.
But the house kept standing.
Yeah.
Because it was founded upon a rock.
Yes.
The Bible says, well, there's another man.
Uh-huh.
A foolish man is a man that hears these words of God and does not put them into practice.
Yeah.
It's like a man who builds his house upon the sand.
Yeah.
And notice that same storm came. The rains descended, the flood came up, the winds beat all around that house, and that house fell.
Yeah.
Why? Because he heard the word, but he did not obey the word.
Man.
Now notice that the storm is coming either way. Whether you're a wise man or whether you're a fool.
Yeah.
Whether you have real faith or whether you have dead. And you walk up to them with a Bible, they're not going to listen to you. But they're blind. I just stopped by to encourage somebody that if he did it for me,
yeah.
And he's able to do it for you, that he's singing in a song that there is no secret but God can do what he's done for others. He will do for you with arms open wide, he'll pardon you because there's no secret what God can do. Are there any witnesses in the house this morning?
Here.
Lord, you know what they came here lacking. You know, every void, every empty place in their life. You know, every misplaced priority. Father, I'm asking, oh God, that you would just bring it to the forefront of their hearts and their minds. And then help them, oh God, not to just be hearers of the word, but doers. Give them feet for their faith. Give them the confidence and the boldness, oh God, to get up right where they are and say, I'm not leaving here the same way I came. This load is too heavy for me to continue to carry. I'm going to cast it at the feet of Jesus. And I'm going to pick up his load. I heard that his burdens are alike. Lord God, you said in your word that any man that calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Father, I'm asking right now that you would do what God does. Save your children. Save your children. We love you, we thank you, we trust you in all things. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.